this demo, let me show you what you can do with the Solution Builder and introduce some exciting capabilities as part of this December release. Solution Builder will be moving out of the beta into the general availability. Solution Builder introduces the ability for the customers to design end-to-end network edge topologies using a drag-and-drop functionality in the portal. The customer can also generate download estimate prices on a single page for the designed topology. Solution Builder now supports local currencies, redundant devices, clusters, redundant connections, bring your own connections, device link groups. In the future, Solution Builder will be supporting ordering and deployment functionality. Let's log in to our Equinix Fabric portal. Under the top menu, you see a menu called Build Solutions. When you use Solution Builder for the first time, you will see the options to create the design immediately. You can click the untitled name on the top and name your design. On the left side, you'll see all the resources available to design the digital network. You can simply drag and drop resources to the canvas, configure the options, and connect dots of each resources. Now let's create a sample network and get the price estimate for this digital network design. Suppose I want to build a hybrid cloud network across three cities. For my multi-cloud environment, I use AWS in the DC area and Microsoft Azure close to my Silicon Valley metro. To do this, I'll simply search AWS and Microsoft Azure from the resource, then select metro location for those cloud network providers. In order to connect those two cloud environments, I would like to use Cisco Catalyst 8000V Cloud Router. By using Network Edge BNF Router, I can route multi-cloud environment traffic without having a dedicated router instance in each cloud environment and saving money by paying flat rate from the Equinix, rather than worrying about monthly cost based on the egress data traffic cost. In this demo, let me use a single device. I have to name the device, then select the vendor and other options to determine the price for this virtual device. Once you are done selecting options for the router, simply connect the dots to each CSP resource and select the bandwidth for each connection. I am now adding cluster firewall to my Silicon Valley location. Let me drag and drop Palo Alto Networks VM series firewall in a configured option. In order to connect multiple devices, I will be using something called a device link group or DLG. This allows us to connect multiple devices in the same or different metro locations. In case I'm connecting my corporate network through my network service provider, I can use this resource called Bring Your Own Connection or BYOC. This allows me to extend my corporate LAN or WAN network into an Equinix IBX data center and connect to the network edge virtual device. You can simply drag the BYOC resource object to the canvas and configure the options. You first need to provide a network service provider name and select the metro and IBX data center location. This is something that you can ask your network service provider to get the information. Now you need to select your port speed and click Save. After saving BYOC object, I can simply connect this object to my existing firewall to bridge the cloud network and my corporate network. You still have to configure the virtual connection bandwidth between those objects. Now, let me add another routers in the Asia Pacific Metro, which is in Sydney. If I'm using a similar configuration, you can simply duplicate the router, change the metro location for this duplicate router. Because I want to connect this new router to my existing backbone network, I can draw a line between the routers and the existing DLG object. In the DLG configuration, you can simply use the same bandwidth speed or select a different bandwidth for each connection. As you can see, the price will be automatically calculated based on the local currency of the metros that the device is deployed. Now my design is complete. Let's look into the price estimate of the entire design. On the top bar, you'll see a section called a Show Pricing Summary. If you click there, you are going to see the Pricing Summary section on the right. In the December release, we have enhanced this section to make it easier for the user to group objects. Location View simply groups the object into each metro location and calculate total itemized price based on its local currency. You can drill down each metro and then find your device with information and price details. Resource View will group objects based on the device type and service. This view will be super useful in case you want to understand how many metros are included in a specific device link group. If you go back to the location view, you can simply export the pricing summary as a nicely formatted quote in a PDF format. This will conclude this demo of the Solution Builder. Thanks for watching.